All right, here we have the culmination of about somewhere between 5 and 7 years worth of work of the Dwarven Fortress, which started with the original, now small, Bugman's throne room. And then eventually, the second piece was the Dwarven Fortress here. And then the most recently completed was the Dwarven Hall attachment, which is here. Let's look at some individual pieces. Started probably about somewhere between 5 and 7 years ago with the Dwarven throne room, kind of themed after Bugman. Get a look here at the throne done with gold and silver. I think that was my first attempt at non-metallic metal gold. The stairs going down. Also, a pretty good look at the gemstones done on the platforms. You can also see the knotwork here. Also had some nice little beer barrel columns made with the cake decoration columns from, I believe, Michael's. Another component that I thought was kind of nice on this one was the original carving of the Celtic anvil. So you can see that. That's kind of the ramp that goes up to the throne. And then after 7 years, somehow I found a way to slightly attach that. We'll take a look at the external part next. Let's go over to the Dwarven Fortress. I think this was completed about 3 or so years ago. Here's a good look at the entryway now. Obviously it still has some cobwebs. I just pulled this out of storage and needs a little bit of TLC. The front door has kind of been blasted off the hinges. Obviously the goblins have attacked, but a bear theme. Here you can see another look at the Celtic anvil. But it has a giant platform out front, of which to overlook the lake down below. Also has gathered a little bit of dust. You can see as I wipe that clean, that's a lake down there if I wipe it clean. Also have the big spiral staircase. You can kind of take a look at what that looks like here. Each of the staircases has a little bit of the knotwork on that as it goes down and around. Also a little beer barrel in the team colors. You can see a little bit. It has a couple openings. Here's the anvil rock right here. Opens into one opening. You've got the main opening here. A lake flow waterfall. It looks like it's yellowed a little bit over the years, but ends up down here in the bottom. We also have a side entry over here. Also again with the beer barrel theme. And another entry on the far end. Down here, you can kind of see the little platform there as that goes up. Also on top, the Dwarven copter landing pad here, the secret port entry here, that opens up, kind of, it's got a cave going down, ramp, runway, going across, another landing pad over here. But it has these two statues up front that I think are pretty neat. I think they're out of print, no longer available. But again, you can see underneath you've got a lot of the cake decoration columns designed. Here's a little bit of the look from the front. Now, as we look on to the third piece and the most recent piece, this is the Dwarven Hall, at least the outside of it, complete with the doorway for scale. Let's look at one figure sitting down there. Okay, so you've got the door that opens. That's a functional door. Eventually we'll have a bridge piece to come up here, but you've got the braided beard and mustache coming from the dwarf. The dwarven head, complete with Celtic knotwork. on the helm with the hair. Also has some bigger pieces here. Again, the other side coming down. I built a little, I got a little blimp action here. You can also see a little bit of the design on that one. The lighting is not the best, but with a dragon wing, two-headed dragon blimp. An anchor is built in to tether that. The block is removable, but you can see that there's a flat space there to place that. Also on the other side, I've got a wall here in which you would have all your war machines and possibly crossbow. And here's the upper lake here. It's not quite finished with the coloration. I've got to add some more colors here and some more still water and add a little bit more flow to that, along with adding some of the white snow effect in order to get the look from the waterfall. Here's one in process. It just takes a long time, and the waterfall coming down here into the pool. You can see that this hasn't quite done what it needs to do. What happened was one of the products kind of leaked a little bit, and what I had to use was a different product that was not very good, and I'll probably have to redo that area right there. But you can see that's the lower waterfall as it comes back, coming out and flowing from the lake here, and originating from the understreams up here. Also, we've got, oh, what's this? A little gyrocopter here, flying around. A set for another set of war machines on the backside. So you've got a lot of fancy little terrain on that. Also, it goes a taller back panel. From the back, you can even see some of the components from that process. Let's go in and take a look at the inside. We're going to go back over since the throne room is pretty much uncovered. We're going to work our way all the way around to the back side of everything, and to kind of see how it all connects. The throne room starts here. I'm around on the back side. You would go down the throne room through these gates, and then the gates then would come. Here's the other way of looking at the gates. All right, let me make it so it's not so shaky here. You can see the throne room from the inside. There's the Bugman's design, some Celtic knot work. You can see the Celtic knot work coming up on the floor. Here's an interesting stone design. Looks like malachite granite with runes. Little anvil. The cool thing about this is this does rotate. Originally, this was going to be one of the rune anvils and be flat, but I liked it so much I mounted it on the wall. You've got some nice little design here. Here's the inside of the front door. You can see it's got even some dwarven heads on either side. A little bit of knot work with the team colors. Some steps going up. And if you start here looking at the floor, you can look up. And as we continue on, there's also knot work on the ceiling. And so we've got it on the floor. Here's the column where they attach going down. And you can see again the jewel design or gem design with the mountain peak that's kind of holding the back side of the frame up. There's how it looks from here to down. And also, here's your second column to the top. We've got the giant stalactite coming down. Those gems will light up. I have a flashlight embedded in the top part up here. I can turn that on, and it's a special type of stone that will light up. Maybe I can add that later on. You can see the twin split stairs. One goes to the secret cave, or the secret, area through under behind the waterfall. Here's looking at from the other direction. You can see going up the split staircase and into an exit through this room here. Another interesting thing is the water fountains coming out through the top. If you can get a good look, little dragon heads spouting water and landing in the collection pools. Now, I haven't quite finished the collection pools. Those will have, I think, using the snow effects to and get a little splash action. Right now they've got the water in there is all they have so far. But again, you can see some of the gemstone design on that process. Now, in theory, the hall connecting the throne room through the gate, portcullis, past the main front door all the way out. If you were to exit through this location right here, I don't know if you can see. Let's see if we can make that work. It kind of opens up into, not with a phone anyway, into the brewery. I'm going to slide this back for just a moment to kind of show you what it looks like where they were to connect. You have the top floor of the brewery room here. Looks like one of the pieces has fallen down, but we'll get that fixed. The down lower floor. We also have, as you can see, this has been kind of in storage for a little while. Got the elevator piece. Technically, it's a working elevator with the pulley, but I think it's kind of fallen off, kind of like the door hinges right here. It has a gate as well. Let's see. My upper floor is a little bit fallen down from what it looks like. It's held up by columns. All those columns straightened out. Right side up. You can see that goes up to the secret door trap, the second floor. Here's one of the other exits. Some of the rune design. That's the broken door from the inside. Bottom floor, a little bit more intricate design. Also on the wall, some different designs. I think I've got some decoupage. Dwarven hero portraits. Also here. And then there's the brewery there. You can see a little bit of it there. And then where that connects is simply the hole here. My plan is to have a some kind of a fake portrait, but you really can't see it, so I didn't put it in. Once I close this up where these pieces meet, and now it's sealed again to where you can kind of see how it all kind of flows together. So a person, if they were invading, would come in, looks like they did, through the broken door. Oh my gosh, I opened this door here. Looks like I broke that door too, but you can see I'm kind of brutal on this. I guess I'll have to fix those. You could go in through there, climb up this step here through that doorway, and you would eventually come out over here. I'll slide this back a little bit so we can kind of see more of what's in here. There's the door that they would be coming through in order to enter that. And this also, that's my finger, would be the door going out into the area. So that's the whole piece. After about 5 to 7 years, but again, that's the this is the Dwarven Hall. This piece here being Dwarven Fortress, also with a spiral staircase coming in, and then eventually leading all the way in your battles all the way to the throne room. That's some of the back side of the top here. That's the old working gate. Well, that's me. I don't even know if I'm in the picture, but thanks for taking the time to check it out.